Here we are, Sharjah Masters round six, and I've been joined by Salim Saleh, who I'm just being told, of course, you were Asian champion 2015. Yeah. They wanted me to mention that. So, but that's one of your many achievements, of course.
Yeah.
So how many points do you have at the moment?
No, I have... how many points do I have? How many rounds we played?
We've played six rounds.
So I have four.
Four points. Yeah. Okay, so far it's been a little bit of a rocky ride.
Yeah, but it could be worse. So I'm optimistic about the next round. So it started difficult, but now it's getting better.
Yeah great.
Especially that today I won against Shahriyar Mamedyarov's sister.
Turkan.
Yeah, Turkan. Yes. Yeah. Okay.
So you have black here.
I have black, and she usually plays e4. I prepared for e4, and she played very rarely d4. I was not expecting, but by luck, I saw that she's taking on e5 after e5. So I started to think here what to do.
So you wanted to avoid some...
Some drawish position, yeah. So, okay, I played c5, d5, okay, e6, castle, maybe... I mean, I played too fast here because rook e8 is the best move. Mm. But maybe considering the situation, I had to play e5, which is very risky. But normally, when white castles already, you can do it. Of course, it's a very good position for white.
So to close, like just transpose into a king's Indian. But
yes.
But normally, with the king in the middle, then
yes, then white can play h3 g4. And but for example, with the castle, then h3 is not good move for white. Here, it's very good actually set up for white. Because whenever I want to play f5, white can play like g3, and knight h4, still the king side is very solid.
But that would probably be a very unexpected move, e5. I mean, this is a very tricky position,
yes,
isn't it?
Yes, and I don't think she has experience in this line, but I played too fast rook e8. And then,
5 seconds, it says.
Yeah. And then I started to regret when she played h3, because there was, I think, a game here between... Nakamura Morozovic, and I think white went something like knight d2 to take with the c, the c pawn, and that is like ambitious, but it's good version for black, because black, for example, after knight d2, black is not taking quickly on d5. Black's playing knight a6, knight c7 first, preparing not to give c4 square so quickly, to be ready for it. So she played h3, and then I realized, so now I will have to take. I spend a lot of time actually here because, but actually I don't know what to do, because if I would have played, for example, knight a6, now white can take. Bishop takes and some bishop f4.
Really?
And knight is very strange on a6. Normally if you would have it on c6, you can even give the pawn. And I was calculating some queen b6, I mean some move like bishop f8 I would never play, bishop d7 I considered, but I didn't like any. I'm not sure if it was, maybe it was playable, but somehow I didn't like it. So take. Yeah, of course I'm playing objectively, I think, the best moves, but the tricky part is that in this position, to improve your position, you have to exchange piece. With every exchange, your position is getting better, but it's getting nearer to draw. So I don't know what to do. Okay, I played bishop f5, bishop d3. We exchanged two pieces already. Here, I think that queen d3, for example, or queen c2. Is better than what happened, because for instance rook here and then bishop d2, bishop c3, just to dry out everything, because white is already not better.
But it's interesting, the situation you're describing is so typical of modern day chess, actually, that very often you're playing players that are a little bit weaker than you. With white particularly, they play very solidly, but you want to play for a win. So in general, what is your attitude in that situation? Do you like to sort of complicate? Do you think it's best to play very steadily? Or, how do you approach these situations?
I prefer actually to have very complicated positions because I believe that I should be better in any kind of chess, but I think in calculations it's much easier.
That's your forte.
Yes, and it's much easier for them to go wrong in calculations. Of course, I can see tactics, some of them, but I think that I can calculate better.
Okay.
And in some positional game, sometimes it's not difficult to play. That's the problem, And, I don't know, it's a tricky part. That's why I'm suffering here. takes. Yeah, I think that queen d3 was better. Rook e1, she played. It's an interesting idea that I cannot take here. just because of queen e2, and then queen e8, and I still not in time to go out. So takes, I don't think that rook e1 was a good move. Knight d7, now I was quite happy, but she played rook b1. I think it's a good move. Very simple move, but...
just to develop the bishop.
Yeah, and to play b3, and I mean, just to get out from this pin.
It looks very equal, it has to be said.
Yeah, and do you know what was the problem? That I have to play knight e5 next move. I mean, I spend here some time, not like 11 minutes, because I don't want to play knight e5. But what else? I mean, I was trying to make some b5 works, for example, some Benko kind, but I did it once and it didn't go very well, so I... I mean, I was not sure if it's so great, so take. You know, also the problem that I have sometimes first rank problems, for example, just b4, and I don't know what to do, just to change everything, not even playing ambitiously, you know?
Yeah.
So I thought that better to play knight e5.
Okay, so it's all very steady so far. So let's rattle on with the game, because it's quite a long game.
Okay, bishop e3. Okay, here it's quite equal, I don't know. Ah, yeah, here was, I think this b4 was a position mistake. I was very happy. I was, okay, I wanted to play myself a6, b5, but there was always b4 when I play a6, for example.
Ah, okay.
And she played voluntarily b4. It doesn't look so bad, but I think that it was a mistake.
I suppose it means that c4 is now weaker.
Yes.
It gives you at some point, perhaps, a target.
Yeah, and I think she had concrete idea. That's why she played b4, because takes, and queen a5. She wanted immediately to attack a7 pawn. And here, of course, I think she missed the move that I have played. I played rook b8.
Mm.
And here, it was interesting. There was a nice line. Okay, queen a7. Maybe not the best move, but I don't know what to do already. Rook b1. And yeah, the reason behind this check was a good move, actually. Because if queen a4 immediately, I suppose she saw it. Queen d3, bishop c1 is only move. Takes, and bishop f4. And I thought if bishop f4, I'm winning this endgame because of rook d4, rook takes c4, and I'm not losing the c-pawn.
Okay.
Even if I lose it, maybe it's winning, I don't know, but it would be difficult.
Ah, with the king on g7, she has bishop
With the king
b2
on g7,
check.
There's a bishop b2 check.
Oh!
So, okay.
Let's just show that.
That's okay, so queen a8, king here, queen a4, of course here if queen d3, as the previous variation, takes, bishop f4, and bishop b2 check.
Okay, yeah, okay, it's not enough, I was dreaming of some
Coming black
square or something, yeah.
Yeah, so here, queen here. Yeah, here I had, I think that maybe h5 was stronger than e4, and I wanted to play it, but suddenly, because the point is, white does not have moves here. And if I move my queen, then g3, like happened in the game. And my idea was h5, to keep h3 hanging. For instance, if g3 here, okay, because no moves, it's not so easy.
Strange position.
Yeah, but finally I was worried about some move like f4, which is very strange. Okay, I don't know what's happening here. Okay, it should be good for me, but... Okay, I can play rook b4. What? I thought... But okay, queen moves... I was not sure. It should be good for black. H5 is a very interesting move, I think. Queen e4, then g3 is only
move. But in that position, after f4, rook b4, so...
Yeah.
So, I mean, for example, queen a6, can't you just take on an f4?
Yeah. No, queen e8, I thought, actually, in the game, and rook f1. Ah, but then bishop h2. Ah, okay.
Yeah. Yes.
Okay, it should be good. I played queen e4, threatening queen c4. I mean, or taking queen c4, sometimes queen c4. g3. And, okay, rook b4.
It also looks very nice for you.
Yeah, it's very nice, but I wanted to be precise. I mean, I wanted to play, for instance, rook b2 and just to take on g3, not to waste time on those pawns. But this rook e1 comes by tempo. There is bishop h6 threat, and if this, then queen goes to d1 back. So I had to kick queen first to far not to come back to d1.
Mm.
But here, if rook b2, then bishop f4 is the problem.
Okay.
And okay, once changing this bishop, I have I don't know what I have, nothing. Okay, so if queen f3 with rook b2 idea, it was something that I didn't like. Yeah, maybe. Maybe this move. And if rook b2, then bishop takes c5. But okay, bishop takes g3, bishop d4. Okay, I think that what I played is good. Rook takes c4. Bishop g5. Okay, threatening bishop e7 and some ideas. Queen f3. Yeah, here I was calculating rook f1, and then it's finishing. I mean, bishop g3 is just finishing, because if take, then it's just mate.
Okay, we know that one.
This mate. Okay. And if... I mean, I was... Okay, bishop h6 is nothing. I just queen f8 and I go. And what else? And suddenly I noticed there is this move. I panicked a bit because, okay, I after take, I cannot protect f7, but I have this check. And then I take.
Yeah.
Okay. So she played rook e1. Of course, I think she saw my first game here, and she understood that I am talented in, you know, getting mated, because after bishop bishop g3, there is queen f8.
Oh. So just to explain, king takes bishop, but let's just show that.
Yeah.
So...
Queen f8,
queen
and
f8, bishop
takes
h6.
Bishop h6, and it's mate.
Yeah. If I can play it out, that's better.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
And it's actually easy to miss this move.
Yeah.
So I played rook c2, and she played bishop e3. And now I wanted to take bishop g3, but again, queen f8.
Queen f8.
Okay, I don't know what happens after king f6, but...
yeah,
I
you
mean,
don't want to examine
yeah.
that.
Okay, here I had, I mean, choice to... for example, queen d5, there was something that I didn't like. I wanted to make just h5 to get out of, you know, this threat.
Yeah.
And to take bishop g3, but then I didn't like that. Maybe queen a4, okay, threatening this rook, keeping the pawn for a moment. Okay, it shouldn't be good for white anyway. I took the pawn, queen e7, now it's, okay, it's just... Yeah, here I was spending time for some reason. I couldn't see. I mean, finally, when I found queen e6, I was happy. It looks completely winning, but what to do? The problem, if I move the queen like to f3, there is always bishop c5. I was calculating some move like queen f3, bishop takes, and queen c3, rook c1, rook a1, and bishop e3, protecting everything.
I guess you still got to be careful, because you know your back rank is a little bit exposed, and there are tactics around the dark squares. So
yeah, and if f6, then always queen e3. This was the problem. Yeah. This. So I was happy when I found this queen e6. Looks strange move, but the point is, okay, if bishop c5, then f6, and now it's okay. It's over. Queen h4, threatening mate in 2 again. So h5. Queen g5, okay, rook a1, and here I was of course expecting that she will not change rooks, and play bishop, sorry, it's happening with the mouse.
Yeah, bishop c1, yeah.
Bishop c1. And okay, I was thinking, then I spotted bishop f4.
Oh, very nice.
And if bishop b2, then just move the king, to h7.
Huh.
Everything is hanging, but it's lost, I mean, if I calculated right.
Okay, so the queen is hanging, this is hanging, yeah.
Yeah, and my queen is protected, it's pinned, and, okay. Yeah.
Very nice. So, okay, she... Sorry.
Okay, she changed the rooks, then, okay.
And then it's very, very easy. Okay, so you have... Okay, we'll just play the last moves.
Okay, I could also allow queen h6 and go to g8, but thought better not to allow any check on it.
Yeah. Okay, so now you're back up to 4 out of 6, so... the wind is in your sails, last three rounds.
Hopefully, yeah. I hope that, okay, we'll play better in the remaining.
And just generally, how have we chatted in the Baku Olympiad. I mean, how have things been going in the past 6 months or so for you? Have you been playing much?
I didn't play much. I mean, I played in Isle of Man in October, and then I stopped for a while. I played Rapid and Blitz in Qatar. In Blitz, I played actually quite well. I finished 13th, and after that I got the opportunity to play in Grand Prix, so I am playing in this cycle. I played the first one in Sharjah, and okay, in Sharjah it didn't go, I mean, very well or very bad, okay, it was normal,
yeah.
But I'm hoping that I will play better in the next two.
Okay, but it's of course, these Grand Prix tournaments are incredibly tough. I mean, you know, there are absolutely no easy games. So yeah. I mean, do you, that's kind of the next level up for you. Yeah. I mean, how did you feel during that tournament? Was it a bit of a shock, or do you feel like you're getting there?
No, actually, I started bad again. But in the middle of the tournament, I made I made five draws, and then I won one game. And actually, in those draws, I had chances to win.
Yeah.
So I think that I can play better. I mean, I can score, for example, 50% or yeah. 2 for +1. I think I can do it.
Okay.
And I think it's a good result.
Good experience. Yeah. Fantastic. Okay. Well, listen, we wish you well for the rest of the tournament, and. We hope to see you back here with one of your spectacular games.
Thank you.
Thanks a lot.
Thank you.